subscribe to my channel and press bell icon for latest updates.
Hi, welcome to Learning Monkey. I am Raghuveer. In this class, we will discuss about the coding of k-nearest neighbors on Cardio dataset. In our last class, we clearly discussed about the code on Amazon mobile dataset. So please watch that class and come back here, because we are not taking any new code here. The same code is applied on our cardio dataset. So here, coming to cardio dataset, in this cardio dataset we are having only numerical and categorical data. Our Amazon mobile dataset is a text dataset. If your dataset consists of both numerical, categorical and text data set, now then you have to convert your data numerical values into min-max scaling. The scaling technique which we used here is min-max scaling. So our suggestion is to you apply normalization, standardization and change the code based on normalization and standardization, then apply k-nearest neighbors on that new values also. Here we used min-max scaling. In data preprocessing, we discussed that what's min-max scaling, how to apply, what's normalization and how to apply, how to convert our data into normalized data and how to convert our data into standardized data. The first five blocks of the code is a data preprocessing code, which we already discussed in our previous classes. One important point here we have to discuss is we are taking only 10,000 data points out of 67,000 data points we have in our cardio clean data set. 70,000 data points we are having in cardio data set, but we are taking only 10,000 data points because KNN is computationally very difficult, because we need lot of memory space and computation speed so that KNN can be executed very fastly. So because we are having most of the students will have only 4 GB random access memory, it will take around 2 hours time to compute all this KNN training data set. That's why we are taking only 10,000 data. If your random access memory is high, if you are having 16 GB, above 16 GB random access memory, you can take the complete data set and apply k-nearest neighbors. Okay, coming to our coding part, first 5 blocks of the code is a data preprocessing code. We applied min-max scaling here, and the link to download this data set and this coding file is provided in the description below. Please download this coding document and data document and do some modifications so that you will understand the code better and understand the concepts of k-nearest neighbors well. So coming to our next, this is all about training data preprocessing. After data preprocessing, we will divide our data set into training data and testing data. Here we have divided our data into training data and testing data, into a variable called train means training data, test means testing data. After converting our data into training data and testing data, now we will apply our k-nearest neighbors algorithm on training data, and we have to identify the best k value. K is the hyperparameter in KNN. So we have to identify the best k value. For that we have to use grid search CV, and we have given different k values. We have taken only 55 k values. You can take up to 1000 k values so that you will have a better understanding of the graph which we got here below on different k values. We will pick the best k value here. So the best k value we got here is 55. So for that, for picking the best k value, we are using grid search CV. All these discussions were clearly made in our previous classes. We applied this on naive base. We applied this in our previous Amazon data set. That's why we're not going deep into what's the concepts of grid search CV, all those things. Okay, the same code, almost all the models we use the same code with minor modifications. Okay, so after getting the best k value, we got the k value is equal to 55. Now we have to train our model based on this best k value. K is equal to 55, and we have to identify the threshold value, highest threshold value, means where we got TPR into 1 minus FPR value, where we got the maximum TPR into 1 minus FPR value, that threshold value has been considered, and based on that threshold value we have to give the prediction values and identify the confusion matrix for training data and testing data. This is the code for converting or identifying the best threshold value and identifying the confusion matrix for based on that threshold value. Here is our output. So this is all about KNN, applying KNN on cardio data set. Hope you understand the concept. If you have any questions regarding the concept, please post your questions in the comment section below. Thanks for watching. If you haven't subscribed to our channel, please subscribe to our channel and press bell icon for the latest updates. Thank you.